This is not the first time the international community has tried to disarm a Ba'athist regime of weapons of mass destruction, is it? Saddam Hussein's Iraq was also accused of having large stockpiles of weapons, and UN inspectors were sent in to find and destroy them. Back then, the US and its allies didn't wait for the findings of the UN inspectors before they took military action. The rush to war, widely criticized by the man who led the UN inspection team back then. That was Hans Blix. Well, earlier I spoke to the veteran Swedish diplomat and began by asking him how he views these recent diplomatic developments.
I think the opening that has been obtained through Putin's action and through Obama's and the US administration's quick acceptance of this is very welcome, because we were US and the world was heading into something that could be very, very dangerous in the first place in the area. And secondly, it also, I think, would undermine the Security Council. The US would add to the examples of Kosovo and Iraq 2003, a third one of bypassing it and appearing as the world's policeman. This, I think, angered and worried not only the Russians, but a great many people in the world. And I'm sure that if the question had gone to the General Assembly, there would have been a strong majority against it.
How realistic is it that within a couple of weeks' time, we may have got to the point at which Lavrov and Kerry and Assad have all joined hands and says, you know what, we're going to give these weapons up? Just how long does that take and how realistic is it?
To send inspectors out in a country where a civil war is raging and removal, that is not easy at all. I don't know whether they have any thoughts of removing it, taking some of it out to Jordan. I'm sure that both the Russians and the Americans are keen that whoever will be in control in Syria will not grab the chemical weapons, not just the regime that could use it, but others could use it as well.
You've been watching this narrative develop over the past couple of weeks. When you sit back and you consider and reflect on what you've heard, how do you assess what we've seen?
Well, I think that there are many aspects of it. And I think originally my interpretation was that this was about the credibility of the US president. He had happened to say that if Syria were to use chemical weapons, that would change his calculation. And I'm sure that his intention was to warn Assad against any use of chemical weapons. And I can understand that. But at the same time, I think he painted himself in the corner. There were many who wanted the US to take action, and many who hoped that there would be a violation by Syria. And so when it came, all these jumped on him and say that now you must act. But there was another credibility. The US president has said that if Iran moves one inch closer to a nuclear weapon, then that we all options are on the table. They're already, but we may take action then. And that credibility was of immense importance to the US Congress and to others as well. So I think that was at stake. Now, that has sunk somewhat into the background. Everybody focuses now on the chemical weapons and the indignation about the use of it, which is understandable. And I think it is fairly wise politically to focus on it. But at the same time, I think we have to recognize that actually removing the weapons will be very, very difficult.